John should send them free, you're good for 24 hours.
When did they not certify? Was that recently?
It's never been certified. It's never been, it's just now turned that it's required. So it used to not even be an issue to certify. Or this is more than certified.
So it's good in November?
Yes, sir, it's good for the constitutional amendment.
Yes, it'll be exempt from this constitutional amendment, but they said for the primaries and then the actual election day for the next big election, that they're not gonna be certified anymore. I wanna say that it was during this special session with the state is when they decided all of this. So it's been just recently. It's not like it's been like this for forever. It's just been recently.
So they're gonna certify and then they're not gonna certify?
So they really didn't have any type of certification for poll books. And then because of the whole deal of election fraud and all that, they decided to do where the poll books have to be certified in some sort of way. And I want to say the reason why they're saying ours isn't going to be certified is because of the programming and the Windows that's on the Windows computer thing that's on our poll books now is the old Windows system. Mm-hmm. And it's they're not
going to update the Windows system on those poll books.
That's going to be something that has to be talked with ESNS, but as far as I know of, there's no way to put the new Windows 11 in there. And so that's as far as I know of for right now.
How many of them do we have? One for each home plate?
That's a good question.
I think about 17, if I'm not mistaken.
You know, that is on the internet base.
Yes, it's all.
But the voting machines themselves are not internet based. If I'm right.
Yes, the poll books. Yes, the poll books are the only things that will be connected to the internet. The voting system itself, you'll have a paper ballot and just put it in there, and you put what you want to vote and everything, and you'll review it, and then you click OK, and it spits that paper ballot back out to you, and then you put it in the DS-200 to cast your ballot.
We have a little demonstration on that, probably. Mm-hmm. Realize how they did that. But if it's two separate things totally, the toll book is just keeping current who has already voted, so that you can't vote same way.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Since that is so separate, that seems strange that they would have to be certified in a certain way. That's our state government.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go into budget review. The sergeant that we have currently for the DPS district, we had the sergeant in Limestone County. And if the sergeant is in, where the sergeant is where the main office is. Well, that sergeant left, so they moved the main, they moved the sergeant back to this, to Freestone County. And so this is the main DPS office for the two counties. And they were requesting that their DPS person be changed from being a secretary, which is what she was kind of before when the sergeant was in Limestone County, because they had their administrative assistant in Limestone County. But now, the one, since the sergeant's here, now the administrative assistant job is moved here too. And they were asking that we did have the DPS clerk or secretary actually in the first salary grade, and he is asking that we be moved, that she be moved to the second, or that position be moved to the second salary
Job duties.
Yes, and he did give us a written, some written piece of the first showing what moved over here before it was more clarified than the troopers that were assigned in Bristol County. But,
Last time I talked to him, we are full of troopers now.
We are. He said we were full. Maybe he has one coming, or how it makes it.
He had one started the 23rd, I think.
I'm gonna watch him do it.
We have a discussion. But if you'd like to rush in, we can have a discussion, that's what we want to talk about.
I'd like to watch him do it.
Sorry.
Any discussion? If not, all in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Okay, what is that motion?
The motion is to move the, to change the DPS secretary in, grade one to, the DPS administrative assistant, which would be in the second grade. The same as a clerk one. Mr. Newsom had requested an increase in pay. We, in order to do that, we would need, and we can this, next month, whatever, discuss what we pay part-time. Right now, we pay $12, except road and bridge, we pay $15, up to $15. Up to $12 for regular part-time. So, and that can be changed if we decide to do something different.
Can we wait there?
Yes, whenever we talk about it, we're going to change it. Constable precinct two. Have requested, have requested some software for doing his reports. Is that basically what it's called?
So it's report writing and collecting data, and, basically that program that I was asking for, I can, if I take somebody in custody, I can photograph and put it in, I can photograph and put it in that system. But you actually go and look at that data, so I did, and he was certainly on it. To get four constables put on net data, and I looked at the program, which is a nice program, but I don't think it's worth what they're asking for. They're wanting $12,600 just to put it in, and then $5,995 to maintain it a year. And I think it's cost effective for the county, you know, that. As much as I would love to have a program, I don't know if all the constables would do it.
What did you say that they, constable precinct three, if you use something that you're meant to?
McGowan's using our system.
He's using their system. The problem is, I asked them, if I got on that system, all that data would go into his database, which would skew his report when it comes to the end. He put it in miscellaneous.
Yeah, if you put it in miscellaneous, it doesn't skew my numbers.
But the only thing is, it doesn't do me any good, but that puts me right back to not having a system that I can pull the data out of. So I have to go back and just do it manually. If I'm gonna do that, I might as well continue to do it manually. There's no sense of getting on a system that I can't put data on. And so, with the program that I'm asking for, I can do that. I can keep track of my evidence. If I collect evidence, I can take care of any data that I have that I put in it. I can extract it. When I do my NIDAS report, if I raise a profile, I gotta get that information. But Otherwise, I'd have to go in and do it manually, start pulling it out of that. I mean, I see that option, but if I'm gonna do that, I might as well go back to an empty tank and continue to do it that way. That's why I asked.
Mr. Perez is here, and we're gonna talk about the ambulance situation here. Let me go and go in and make a copy of this again, and do the first one.